Friends of Imaginary Goddess, and I'm doing a new Asha from Neonectar deck profile. So my starter is Maiden of Delphinium. It's a promo from a while ago. She is DB1 at the beginning of your main phase. You can choose one of your units, and this unit in this card is regarded as I run two of these because it's a copy target for Asha's Break Stride ability, and you can just have tons of copies on the field. It's just a decent thing to have. So, for my trigger lineup, I run four draws. My draw of choice right now is Maiden of Eggplant. I run 8 crits. So I run 4 of the Cactus Guy because I love his art so much. And 4 of Asha's crit trigger. So you put in Soul when your Vanguard with Ranunculus attacks. +5 to your Vanguard and draw. So that's pretty good. And then 4/7/4 heals. And I run the Fairy Light Dragon from the new Mega Card. Okay, so that's the G's. That's the zero. For grade ones, I run 4 of Asha's new grade ones. So she has Pure Maiden Secreta. She has Bloom, Auto, DB1. When another one of hers placed on Rigorous Rigor, it gets plus. You can choose 4 of them and they get. You can choose 5 of them and they get plus 4. So he becomes 12k, and then you place another one. Because when you first place her, she can give it to herself. And then say that you place another one, it gives it to herself, and the other one is already on the field. So you start getting double powers, and then if your starter's on the field with the name that you've already chosen, then it's pretty okay. I run 4 Early Flowering Maidens. She is Asha's grade 1 from DB4. She is once per turn. You can put 2 normal units from your drop zone and put them on top of your deck. If you have a 9-4 standard, you can choose 4 Pias and they get +3 utility, and then you shuffle them. So she helps get a power boost, and she's pretty good. So yeah. And then I run 2 Valkyrie Reclamation Panini. She is the Stride Fodder for Asha. I'm not really going to go into what she is because she's been around for a while. I only run 2 because she was just my grade in my 2 slot, since I didn't want to run less of any of my other ones. And then I run 4 Maiden of Passion Flower, as my perfect art is the Unflipping G, so it can only guard the Vanguard, and needs to have a copy in your drop zone. Alright, for grade 2s, I run 4 Ideal Maiden Furia. She is Asha's new grade 2. She has continuous GB1. When she's about to be placed, you get to choose one of your units that's already on the field. And if you have an Asha Vanguard, she becomes that unit. So she becomes the next one. And then her auto GB1, at the beginning of your main phase, you can choose a card with the same name as her, return it to deck, and then return her in. So, say that you call her during your stride phase. So you use Asha's stride ability to kind of watch one copy or three cards. So you copy a third. And say that we have a Katrina on the field, and obviously we have another Thuria. So this Thuria is coming in with a copy of Katrina, and she copies the name of Katrina. So at the beginning of the main phase, you have a Thuria and a Thuria Katrina. So this Thuria can put a copy of herself back on top of the deck and reshuffle it. And then this Thuria who is also a Katrina, can put a Katrina back in the deck and then bounce her back to him. You normally don't want to throw something that you just put on the field because it already has plus 2 to mark your stability, but it can help you get normal units back in the deck if you have any ideas, if you haven't had other cards that let you do that, so she's pretty good and helps with get constant. One of the new things is Green Shot Elf. I run 4 of her. She is Bloom, kind of CV1. When she's placed, you can choose off the 5 Green Shot Elves, the plus 2 and the booster one. So this helps that if you have already 2 grade 2s in the front row, looks like you have a column of Green Shot Elves that are able to actually like screen boost and do stuff. So it's pretty good once you get everything up and going. You can hit numbers and have that pesky trouble of having grade 2 in the back row. It's pretty decent. And then I run 3 Maiden of Flower Screen. She's an old card, you can use a promo. You can choose a normal unit from the drop zone, put it back in the deck, and you can choose something and she's regardless of that regard. I run 3 of her because I wanted to run 4 Thuria, because she sets up a lot more abilities, and sometimes I just don't want to add more normal units back in my deck when there's not many triggers left anyways. And then for grade 3s, of course, I run 4 Ranunculus Flower Maiden Asha. Her on-stride ability is that you can last one, choose one of your regards, copy it from the deck, and it gets plus 6. And then her GB2 is continuous. If you have copies of things on the field, they all get plus 5. So if you have an Asha on your Vanguard Circle, and an Asha on your Regard Circle, they both get plus 5. If there's a Green Shot Elf and a Green Shot Elf, they get plus 5. Passion Flowers, they get plus 5. It's all about copies and such. And then for my secondary 3, I run 3 Maiden of Flower Pistol. She is a promo from a while ago. She is also a copy. She's also a name copier. She's, when something else is placed on Regard Circle, she can be regarded as that character. Turn. So say that you have her on Regard Circle, and you're not as a Vanguard, it doesn't matter who your Vanguard is, it could be just a Flower Pistol. But say that a Green Shot Elf is placed, her ability says that she can become a Green Shot Elf, so when Green Shot Elf is placed, Green Shot Elf can give herself and the pistol Green Shot both 10k, or both 2k and more. So then you could move both into the back row per se, and then call new units to the front row, and you have 11k and 13k boosters. Just a bunch of little shenanigans can go on when you have a bunch of things that can copy names. So now we go on to the grade 3s. I run, or the grade, the strikes. So, I run 2 Dream Spinning Renunculus. Awesome. She is the triple rare Asha Stride. She is, once per turn, choose a copy of her face up, and turn it face up, and until end of her turn, she gets, if you have 2 or more units that have the same name, your entire front row gets plus 5. Then if you're in GB3, she was printed before they started putting that on cards, you get to have Asha's Bright Stride ability, which is copy something and give it plus 6. I only run 2 because I only have 2. I'm looking maybe to run 3 or 4 once the G-Zone increases. It helps Asha get all through GB2 in case you can't stride more often than you'd like because your deck isn't giving you things. She helps crush her out as your first stride because she's giving your front row plus 5. plus whatever additional little shenanigans you have going around. And she's also a key piece in the new Asha GR, Ranunculus Glorious Bloom Asha. So she's DB2. Once per turn, you can counterblast one, soul blast one. She's fully face down card, so it's completely copy of her, a copy of Dream Spinning, a copy of whatever else may be in G Zone, and trying to face up. But she has to have Ranunculus as a heart, so you can't just run her in any need. This can be run in any need. It's a pretty good staple, I'd say, at least run two. In any new deck, he helps you get off DB2 and other decks. She's really good at playing Prepper in your first try. But she is, choose one of your Rearguards and copy it. Call it to the field. And then choose up to four of the unit that was called or chosen, and they get +5 for each of this option. Face up in your DB2. So the max I can do is +6 because I only have 2. But you can get a single card to be up to 20 if you have 4 of them face up in your DB2. And then the second part of her ability is when you're paying costs and such and such. Then if you have a unit with the same name, so if you have, like, say that your starter or Flower Screen, things that can copy your Vanguard's name. Like beginning of main phase, you can say that she's considered either a Glorious Bloom or just regular Asha. But she gets a crit if you have a copy of herself on the field. So what you can do is just set up your columns as big as you want. So say that your columns are just going to be a bunch of green shot elves, because that's how things turn out. And then at the beginning of the main phase, you just said that Dolphinium is going to be an Asha. So your Vanguard columns now getting a crit, and then each of your columns are getting +10. +20 because each of them is getting +10. So you're hitting for ridiculous numbers with your Vanguard being at double crit. So that's always really good pressure. You can run up to 4 of her. I suggest running at least 2. One is pretty stable if you're an Asha deck. It's just a really good thing to put in there. The more Dream Spinning you can run, the better. And then the other Stride I run is Sacred Tree, Dragon, Jingle Bell. Once per turn, she's a copy of herself, turn to face up. And then you choose one of your units, and until end of turn, all of your units, including your Vanguard, get +2 for each unit on the field. So say that you have a bunch of things that are copying your Vanguard, look, your field gets +12. Or you have just your rear guards that are all the same name, but they get +10. Everything gets +10. So the thing is really about making big numbers and big hits. So you might be looking at my G zone and being like, oh well, if she uses Asha, the triple R first try, then how does she get off easily running 2 Glorious Ashes and 4 Jingle Flowers? Well, I like to have the option of either turning a Glorious Bloom face up with her own ability, or turning a Jingle Flower face up. So that I can either use Jingle Power twice, or I can use Asha twice. It gives me options, and that's really all I can muddle with 8 G-Zone. But once things change, there might be a new way that I'm going to be putting G-Zone together. So, yeah. So that's my off the deck profile. See y'all later.